So today we'll be taking a break from our Commonwealth series, but we won't be going too far. We are discussing about a sport that is prominently played in these Commonwealth countries. And as you might have guessed it right from the title, it is cricket, our own beloved sport. But the country which we'll be discussing today is not a Commonwealth country. This country is the Netherlands, which plays exceptionally good cricket despite being a Commonwealth country, or despite having any links to the British Empire, or despite being near any country which has links to the British Empire. So now you will say Netherlands playing good cricket, kuch hajam nahi hui baat. So don't worry, let me explain. There are 104 ICC members, of which only a handful have ODI status. Among them, Netherlands ranks 12th. Now that is an astonishing fact. So hello everyone, namaste, annyeonghaseyo, konnichiwa, salyu, and this time in Dutch as well, hallo. This is Vishal and welcome to our channel Indica Central. Over here we discuss world history and current affairs from India's perspective. So let us have a look at the 20 teams which have ODI status by ranking. England at the top, obviously the team believed to be the origin of cricket. So next is India, again a colony of England, New Zealand, South Africa, Australia, Pakistan, again colonies of England, Bangladesh, they got independence from Pakistan but a common colony of England previously, Sri Lanka, again a colony of England, West Indies, a group of countries colonized by England previously, Afghanistan, not a colony of England but they are near Pakistan, and the most prominent cricketers today of the Afghan team, they learned cricket from the Afghan refugees during the Taliban times. Ireland, a colony of England. Now we have at number 12 the Netherlands, not a colony of England, in fact they were themselves a colonial power. Then we have Oman, not a colony of England but dominated by immigrants who come from South Asia, mainly India and Pakistan. Zimbabwe, a colony of England. Scotland, a part of the UK. Nepal, not a colony of England but very close to India, having strong ties, they learn cricket from Indians. UAE, not a colony of England but dominated by immigrants who come again from India and Pakistan. Namibia, a colony of South Africa, like they got independence from South Africa, which was a colony of England. USA, interesting case, a former colony of England but today's cricketers can come from the West Indies and South Asia, which were colonies of England. And Papua New Guinea, again a colony of Australia, which in turn was a colony of England. So these are the 20 members with ODI status, but among them, the Netherlands is the only team which does not have any links to the British Empire whatsoever. So let us look at the history as to when did this game begin in the Netherlands. So in the 17th century, England and the Netherlands were allies. They had a lot of trade. So because of this trade, this game also came along with this trade along from England to the Netherlands. Now this was a time when England did not have too many colonies. In fact, the biggest of its colonies were in America. Now in the Napoleonic Wars, that was in the 19th century, again these two nations were allies. So when British soldiers came to the Netherlands, they also brought this game along with them, and they played this with the local population. Now in 1883, there were 18 clubs in the Netherlands. And in fact, the Ajax Cricket Club in Amsterdam celebrated its 175th anniversary in 2017, which is one of the oldest clubs in the country. Today, there are about 50. Now, this game fell out of favor in the Netherlands, primarily during the Boer Wars. Now, the Boers were a community in South Africa, which took their lineage from the Dutch people who settled there during the 17th century. So, the British had a policy after the war to capture these Boers and held them in concentration camps. So this gave somewhat a feeling of distrust among the Dutch population towards the British. Now, even after this, the Koninklijke-Nederlandse Cricket Bond, which is their governing body, it was established in 1958 and it got an associate membership in the ICC in 1966. Now, since then, Netherlands has done some wonders in cricket on the world stage. So the two of them which I prominently remember, one of them was in the 2009 T20 World Cup, its inaugural match with the hosts England, where they defeated it. Second was in the 2011 World Cup in India, again against England, where they came very close to winning the match. And personally speaking, I like whenever Netherlands comes and performs at the World Cups. So today there are about 6500 cricketers in this country. That's it. This is in comparison to about 12 lakh footballers. So football is clearly the most popular sport, not only in the Netherlands, but across the world. And there is no doubt about it. Cricket, on the other hand, has fallen in popularity across the history, but it is steadily rising. But the only worrying matter is that still many people are unaware about it. So now we discuss the reasons for why does Netherlands play such good cricket even today. The number one reason is obviously due to historical significance. Cricket in this country came much earlier as compared to India or Australia or New Zealand, and they have done a good job of successfully maintaining it. France, on the other hand, where some people also claim to be cricket's origin, have almost forgotten the game. In fact, in the Olympics of 1900, the only cricket match which was played was between Britain and France. But today the game is almost non-existent over there. The other reason is obviously a good sporting culture. Now, Netherlands has a good sporting culture and a good infrastructure. Being a developed country, so if you are a youngster, if you want to play some game, you will be encouraged to do so. So if you are a cricketer in this country, you will be at least paid well. So this is in comparison to countries like Nepal, where the game is the most popular, but still it does not play that well as compared to Netherlands. So the most prominent reason undoubtedly is immigration. So if you have a look, the most prominent players in the Dutch team, like Ryan ten Duskaerte, they were not born in the Netherlands. They migrated there from some other country. Ten Duskaerte, for example, was born in South Africa. Their former captain, Peter Boren, was born in New Zealand. Now, Roelof van der Merwe, who has first played for South Africa, he then migrated to the Netherlands and started playing from their side. So even if you have a look at their current squad, you will find that almost more than half of the people, they are not Dutch locals. They are not born in the Netherlands. And even if they are born, like for example, Ehsan Malik, he is not of a Dutch ancestry. He is ethnically a South Asian. And this immigration is also the reason why countries like Canada, UAE and USA are excelling at cricket. Their team is almost fully filled with immigrant populations, mainly from South Asia. So if you ask me, what is the future now? So I would say if they start playing better than what they are currently playing, I can safely say that within the next 20 years or so, they may get an ICC full membership. Now the ICC Super League for ODIs, it's a good way to make them play with the world biggies for World Cup qualification. Otherwise, the World Cup has been reduced to just 10 teams and they no longer have a chance of coming in the World Cups, at least for now. So the only way to make them play better is for teams to play with them whenever they go on a series with, say, England, as they fall in their way. Or countries can call Netherlands to play at their home to get them an exposure. India, for example, has played only 2 ODIs with Netherlands till now, that's it. Otherwise, their only way to get this exposure will be domestic leagues like Big Bash or T20 Blast or Zansi Super League, or for a very few of them, say IPL. Now, Afghanistan, on the other hand, cricket started there in the mid-1990s and suddenly they started playing it so well that they got a full membership in 2017 and they are no longer even kaccha limbus in cricket. So Afghanistan ka we'll discuss in a separate video for now. That's it for today. So I hope this video was of some help to make you understand something new, to teach you something new. If you like this video, please press the like button, please share and subscribe to our channel Indica Central. And also please press the bell icon to get the latest updates for all our videos. Thank you very much. Thanks for watching.